Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. In this lab, we'll examine this network connecting two MST regions, regions 12 and 34, and a pair of switches running rapid PVST+. This time I've pre-configured the network, so we don't have to do any of the initial setup. Instead, let's get started examining the network in step one. It asks what the CIST topology is, and also says to examine the BPDUs exchanged between the MSTP and Rapid PVST Plus switches. What protocol version identifier is specified? So before we jump into the CLI, let's look at the info in the diagram here. For the purpose of the CIST, the important info is MSTI0 and VLAN 1. In MSTI0, switch 1 has the lowest bridge ID, with a priority of 8192. Switch 5 has a VLAN 1 priority of 24576 plus 1 for the VLAN ID, and switch 6 has 28672 plus 1. So switch 1 should be the CIST root of the network as a whole, and the CIST regional root of its MST region, which is region 12. In region 34, both switch 3 and switch 4 have boundary ports connected to region 12, but switch 3 has a lower bridge ID. Its priority is 12,288. So switch 3 should be the CIST regional root of the region, with switch 3 G01 being a root port, and switch 4 G01 being an alternate port to block loops. However, that's not the only possible loop in this LAN. There's also a loop between these MST regions and the PVST Plus switches, so one of these links should be disabled. That raises two questions. Which link is disabled, and which port is in the discarding state? Let's take a look by going on switch 2 first. I'll use show spanning tree MST0 to confirm. So switch 2 G02 is a designated port. As indicated by bound PVST, it is a boundary port connected to a switch running PVST Plus or Rapid PVST Plus. Now let's check switch 5 to see the role of its G01 port. Its role should be the same in all VLANs, but let's check VLAN 1. Show spanning tree VLAN 1. Okay, switch 5 G01 is a root port, so this link between switch 2 and switch 5 is active. So that means that either the link between switch 5 and switch 6, or the link between switch 4 and switch 6, must be disabled. Let's check on switch 6. Again, I'll use show spanning tree VLAN 1. Okay, switch 6's root port is G00 via switch 5. Why did it select G00 as the root port and block its G01 port? Well, both G00 and G01 should have the same root cost. They are both two hops from region 12, which has the CIST root. Via G00, there's one hop to switch 5 and one hop to region 12. And via G01, there's one hop to region 34 and one hop to region 12. The internal cost within a region doesn't matter. Only the external cost. So switch 6 selected G00 because of the neighbor's bridge ID. Switch 5's priority is 24576, and switch 4's is 32768 in MSTI0. As I mentioned in the lecture video, when switch 2 and switch 4 send BPDUs to switch 5 and switch 6, they include their own bridge ID. Switch 2 sends BPDUs with its own bridge ID, and switch 4 sends BPDUs with its own bridge ID. This is slightly different than when BPDUs are sent between two MST regions. For example, when switch 2 sends BPDUs to switch 4, switch 2 specifies switch 1's bridge ID in the BPDUs, not switch 2's own bridge ID. Anyway, we know the topology now. Switch 1 in region 12 is the CIST root, and two links are disabled to prevent loops, the switch 2 switch 4 link and the switch 4 switch 6 link. The second half of step 1 said to check the BPDU sent between the MST regions and the PVST Plus switches to see what protocol version identifier is specified. I'll right-click on the switch 2 switch 5 link, do a packet capture, and click start. It should fill up immediately. Switch 2 is sending 50 BPDUs to switch 5 every 2 seconds, and the CML packet capture only allows 50 packets by default. Select any of these, expand the spanning tree protocol section, and look at the protocol version identifier. It says spanning tree with a value of 0. So this is a classic STP BPDU, even though switch 5 is running rapid PVST+. As I mentioned in the lecture video, links between MST regions and PVST+ switches use classic STP mechanics, not rapid STP. And before moving on, notice the root ID and bridge ID. The root ID has a priority of 8192, it's switch 1, but the bridge ID has a priority of 32768, switch 2's own bridge ID. Now let's contrast that with the BPDU sent from switch 2 to switch 4. Let's start a packet capture on that link, click Start, and then select the first BPDU. Let me point out two things. First, the protocol version identifier is 3 for MSTP. The value for classic STP is 0, the value for MSTP is 3. What about rapid STP? We'll check that in a second. But now, look at the root ID and bridge ID. They are the same. So, although switch 2 sends BPDUs to switch 5 using switch 2's own bridge ID, it sends BPDUs to switch 4 using switch 1's bridge ID. Okay, just to verify the rapid STP protocol version identifier, let's right-click on the link between switch 5 and switch 6 and start a packet capture. Click on any of the BPDUs and look for the protocol version identifier. It's 2, meaning rapid STP. So there are three different kinds of BPDUs being sent in this LAN. MSTP BPDUs between region 12 and region 34 using protocol version identifier 3. Classic STP BPDUs between the MST regions and the PVST plus switches using protocol version identifier 0. And rapid STP BPDUs between switch 5 and switch 6 using identifier 2. Okay, we've analyzed the topology a bit and checked out the types of BPDUs being sent. Now let's move on to step 2. Without changing the CIST route, trigger a PVST simulation inconsistency error. And then we have to fix the error and confirm how long it takes for the topology to recover. So how can we trigger a PVST simulation inconsistency while leaving switch 1 as the CIST route? Think back to the rules we covered in the lecture. If the CIST route is in an MST region, PVST plus VLANs 2 and greater must have an inferior bridge ID to the CIST route. Currently, that is the case. Switch 5's priority is 24576 in all VLANs, and switch 6's is 28672. So to trigger an inconsistency, I'll modify switch 5's priority for VLAN 2. Go to the CLI of switch 5, conf t, and then I'll set the priority to 0. Spanning tree VLAN 2, priority 0. If I open the CLI of switch 2 again, you can see the error message. Blocking designated port G02, inconsistent superior PVST BPDU received on VLAN 2. Switch 5 has declared itself the root bridge for VLAN 2. Switch 6 will accept it, but switch 2 and switch 4 won't. They both block their G02 ports to prevent loops, as I demonstrated in the lecture video. Now that we've triggered the error, let's fix it and see how long it takes to recover. Go back to switch 5, and reset the VLAN 2 priority back to 24576 with spanning tree VLAN 2 priority 24576, and then return to switch 2. The inconsistency won't be cleared immediately, and that's because of the max age timer. Switch 2 G02 still remembers the superior BPDUs it received from switch 5. It will remember the BPDUs for 20 seconds, the max age timer. However, once the BPDUs age out, switch to G02 will forget about those BPDUs and return to the forwarding state. PVST simulation inconsistency cleared on port G02. Now let's move on to step 3. It says to make switch 5 the CIST route by modifying only its VLAN 1 priority. This should trigger a PVST simulation inconsistency error, and then we'll fix it. So I'll open the CLI of switch 5. And let's modify its VLAN 1 priority to make it the CIST route. The current CIST route is switch 1, with a priority of 8192. If we set switch 5's to the same, 8192, switch 5 will actually have a higher priority, because it adds 1 for the VLAN ID, making the priority 8193. So let's set it one increment lower, 4096. Spanning tree VLAN 1, priority 4096. So switch 5 should declare itself the root bridge. Let's check with do show spanning tree VLAN 1. Okay, this bridge is the root. Now let's take a look at switch 2. There's another error message. Blocking root port G02. Inconsistent inferior PVST BPDU received on VLAN 2. So what happened here? It's that second rule we covered in the lecture video. If the CIST root is not in an MST region, VLANs 2 and greater must have a bridge ID superior to VLAN 1. So if switch 5 is the root bridge for VLAN 1, it must be the root bridge for all VLANs. How can we fix this? Let's go back on switch 5. I'll use spanning tree VLAN 2-50, priority 4096. But this won't have any effect. Because PVST Plus adds the VLAN ID to the priority, VLAN 1 still has the lowest bridge ID. Its VLAN 1 priority is 4097, VLAN 2 priority is 4098, VLAN 3 is 4099, etc. So let's set VLANs 2-50 to 0 instead of 4096. Spanning tree VLAN 2-50, priority 0. Now let's go back to switch 2 and see if the inconsistency has been cleared. It hasn't yet, but after the previous BPDUs age out, it should. While we are waiting, let's go back to the lab guide to take a look at step 4. It says to remove VLAN 1 from the switch 2, switch 5, and switch 4, switch 6 trunks. Once again, a PVST simulation inconsistency error will be triggered, and then we should fix it. So the PVST simulation mechanism that Cisco switches running MSTP use relies on VLAN 1, converting BPDUs between VLAN 1 and MSTI0. Let's see what happens when we remove VLAN 1. So go back to the CLI. First, notice that the PVST simulation inconsistency from step 3 has been cleared. And now let's remove VLAN 1 from these trunks. First, here on switch 2 G02. Conf T, interface G02, switch port trunk allowed VLAN, remove 1. And then let's do the same on switch 4. Conf T, interface G02, switch port trunk allowed VLAN, remove 1. Next on switch 5 G01. Interface G01, switch port trunk allowed VLAN, remove 1. And finally switch 6 G01. Conf T, interface G01, switch port trunk allowed VLAN, remove 1. So what happens as a result of this? Let's go on switch 2. We have another error message. Blocking designated port G02, inconsistent superior PVST BPDU received on VLAN 2. So this is another violation of the first rule. If the CIST root is in an MST region, PVST plus VLANs 2 and greater must have an inferior bridge ID to the CIST root. Because switch 5 and switch 6 no longer send VLAN 1 BPDUs, they aren't candidates to become the CIST root. So switch 1 is the CIST root again. But in the previous step, I configured switch 5's priority in VLANs 2-50 as 0. So that's why the error was triggered. Switch 5's bridge ID is superior to switch 1's in VLANs 2-50. To fix it, I'll return to switch 5 and change its priority back to 24576 in VLANs 2-50. Exit, spanning tree VLAN 2-50, priority 24576. And let's return to switch 2. As before, it should take about 20 seconds for the port to recover. Switch 2 G02 still remembers the superior BPDUs it received from switch 5, so we have to wait for those BPDUs to age out. Once they age out, the inconsistency is cleared, and G02 is enabled again. Okay, in this lab, we examined this LAN consisting of 2 MST regions and 2 PVST Plus switches. The key points to remember are those 2 rules. If the CIST root is in an MST region, PVST Plus VLANs 2 and greater must have a bridge ID inferior to the CIST root. And if the CIST root is not in an MST region, PVST Plus VLANs 2 and greater must have a bridge ID superior to VLAN 1. That's all for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members who support me through YouTube channel membership. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, George, Nasir Chowdhury, Gustavo Macedo, Marcel Lord, Dragos Hirnea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Vitaus194, Mark Jackson, Bold1C1U, Gerald Guillaume, Fristas1207, Hector Hernandez, Arpad Conives, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yabuz, Samuel Tavares, Kevin Hayes, Roger Bratseth, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemajev, Cats for Life, Adelson Pereira, Farad69, Madmark50484, Alexandru Stratan, Hiago Bicalho, DMJ2, Kurt Nell, Dear Diso, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Pedro Hartman, TrickyMickey123456, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Toxic, Wilmer Romero, Sinan Sarisenar, Gio, Daniel Andrade, Mike Crumby, Dragos George, Jairo Francisco, Philip Jovanovich, Mateusz Wzaszynski, Ruben Hernandez, Electro Jedi, Trevor Goldman, Gavin Paul Tech, Sunny Idigu, Jeffrey C., Chitsinde, Stephen White, Edificare, Fio Fiohain, Dimitro Lis, Faris Alzaharani, Jean-Marcel Belmont, Mikhail Chapsky, Hemanth Jabalpuri, Dariush D., Juan Morales, Gonzalo Nicolas, Doomed Soul, Christine Schubert, Julio Maya, Josie, Egreso, Komlan Kapedemi, Gokhan Doimez, Hashem Rodef, Anand Abiankar, Clyde Mkorobindo, Okello, Adekola Ismail Salami, Orlando Flores, Ray Enriquez, Adrian Martinez, MD Danielwitz, Avinash KR, Gabriel Afolabi, GG7, Rohan Surti, and Tobe Hedin. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching. Thank you.